Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2003, Readable References. Don't forget to subscribe to the Mr. Excel playlist. I'll be podcasting this entire book. All right, today's tip from Peter Albert. Peter Albert, now, let's talk about VLOOKUP. I'm a huge VLOOKUP fan. For me, VLOOKUP is the dividing line. If you can do VLOOKUPs, everything else in Excel is going to be easy for you. So VLOOKUP lets us look up the price from that table. And we'll be talking about VLOOKUPs more later. So copy this down and everything works, all right? But I have to tell you, I've seen them, I've talked to them, I've met them. There are VLOOKUP haters out there, people who hate VLOOKUP. And one of their complaints is that it is so fragile, that third argument where we said we want the third column, that if someone would decide later on that we need a new field here, maybe like size. All right, first off, there appears to be some sort of a bug that Excel is not recalculating that whole thing. Let me undo, and then redo. There we go. That's weird. I got to report that to the Excel team. But you see that where we were getting price, it's now getting color because it was hard-coded to say they want the third column. All right, and what people do to work around this is this crazy thing with equal match. Go look for the word price in the first row of the table, F4, comma, 0, 0, and that'll tell us the price at this point is the fourth column. So they'll actually do equal VLOOKUP. We're looking up A104 in this table, F4, and then instead of hard coding the number 4, they go do a match. And the match is going to be locked down to the price, so F4 twice to put a dollar sign before the 1, and it's going to be looking through the first row of the table. Whoops, F4 twice, comma, missed the comma. All right, press F4 here, comma 0 for an exact match to the match, and then comma false for an exact match to the VLOOKUP. Yeah, and hey, this works great, and here I only have 6 of them, so it's no big deal. See, if I insert a new one, it will automatically adjust and keep getting the price. But just imagine if you had 1,000 VLOOKUPs, and every single VLOOKUP is going to go redo that match to figure out that price is in the fifth column or fourth column. It's horrible. Tables simply solve this problem. So here's my lookup table. Long before I do anything, I'm going to go here and Ctrl+T to make it into a real table. They're going to call it table 1, but I'm going to call it product table. All one word, no spaces, product table. So now it has a name. All right, so now we have a table named product table. Then we come over here and say we're going to do equal index of those prices. Which price do we want? We want the result from the match of A104 into these items. Exact match. Close parenthesis for the index. This is only doing a single match. It's not doing a match and a VLOOKUP. And it will be much, much faster. Copy that down. All right. And then later on, if we insert the size, so insert column, size, everything continues to work because it's looking for the column called price. And let's say that if we change this to list price, that formula gets rewritten, right? So much, much safer way to go. All right, so many cool tricks in tables. Check out this book from Kevin Jones and Zach Parisi on Excel tables, all kinds of tricks in there. And everything that we're podcasting in August and September is in this jam-packed book, plus a lot of fun. Excel jokes, Excel cocktails, Excel tweets, Excel adventures. Jam-packed in full color. Check it out. Buy this book. I would really appreciate it. All right, today's episode, VLOOKUP is awesome and it's my favorite function, but there's VLOOKUP haters out there that complain that it's fragile due to that third argument. If the shape of your table lookup table changes, the answers will change. One workaround is to replace that third argument with a match, but geez, look, imagine doing a match for 1,000 rows of VLOOKUP. So make your lookup into a table before doing the VLOOKUP. The structured table references will handle if the table shape changes, plus you're not doing a VLOOKUP and a match. Just a single match along with an index, and index is lightning fast. Thanks to Peter Albert for this tip, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.